Hello and welcome to a new road trip on Roads Channel. We will drive on a very spectacular motorway today, on the German A8 motorway between the Austrian border near Salzburg and Rosenheim. I drove on about 70% of the motorway system in Germany, and this one is one of my favorite motorways in regard of the wonderful landscapes around. During the video I will integrate also some pics from the wonderful location of Salzburg, Chiemsee and Rosenheim, so stay tuned for a nice drive through an area with beautiful nature and very rich history. So now we are crossing the border into Germany. Started filming in the border area near Salzburg. The Austrian A1 continues with the German A8. So here is a border controls. They used to do controls from time to time. And now let's say a few words about the beautiful touristic town of Salzburg, one of the biggest in Austria with a population of about 155,000 inhabitants. It lies on the river Cinxxx at the foothills of the Alps, with almost 2,000 meters high peak of Untersberg being just about 16 kilometers away from the town center. Salzburg has a very rich history. It was founded in the 7th century. Its main sources of income were at the beginning salt extraction, trade and gold mining. The big fortress of Hohensalzburg is one of the biggest medieval fortresses in Europe and was built in the 11th century. It dominates the city from above. It's on a hill above the historical town center. Most of the historical center was built in the 17th century. Salzburg became a center for the counter-reformation, so it was a big Catholic stronghold here. Salzburg historical core is thus renowned for its Baroque architecture and is one of the best preserved city centers north of the Alps. It has no less than 27 churches. The historical area is listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1996. And Salzburg is also famous for being the birthplace of the composer Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. So he was born here in Salzburg. And it was labeled Austria's most inspiring city because of its history, culture and attractions. Tourists come to Salzburg to stroll through the well-preserved historical center and admire the scenic alpine surroundings. They outnumber the locals during the peak season. Besides the old town, there are also some other attractions like Leopoldskron Palace. That's a Rococo palace in the southern district of Leopoldskron Moss. Hellbrunn with big park and castles. Anif Castle and Zoological Garden. So there are also a lot of museum, like a big and very interesting nature museum and the Mozart home where the house where Mozart was born and the house where Mozart lived are very nice museums to visit in Salzburg. Salzburg also acts in the winter as a gateway to the big ski areas to the south. I visited Salzburg 3 times until now and I like the city a lot. I'm very, very happy when I'm here. To better understand its beauty, let's see also some photos from the town and enjoy them. And afterwards, we'll drive further towards the big lake of Chiemsee. And I hope you liked the few big pics from Salzburg. And now let's hit the road further. On A8 motorway, like I said, in my opinion, one of the most spectacular motorways to drive in Germany. A8 extends from the Luxembourg border to the Austrian border, where we are now, and has a length of about of almost 500 kilometers. The motorway is still incomplete, as a section between Pirmasens and Karlsruhe was not built anymore. It is a very important east-west transit corridor through South Germany, passing by big cities like Munich, Augsburg, Stuttgart, or Karlsruhe. The section between Salzburg and Karlsruhe was already built in the 30s during the Nazi rule, and was built also in order to show the travelers how beautiful Germany is. So the alignment was chosen also in this regard, and the motorway is built directly at the foothills of the Alps, with some significant height differences, big slopes, tighter curves. They could have surely found an alignment north of the current one, 10, 20 kilometers north of it, that would have been much, much easier to build on. For commuters, surely it's not the easiest to drive motorway because this section is substandard between the Austrian border and Rosenheim, lacking emergency lanes. But for those wanting to admire the landscape around, it's just wonderful to drive. From the motorway, there are access roads to the beautiful mountain valleys to the south. Now we went past by the access road to the Berchtesgadener Alps National Park, the B20, which exit was just after the border. Berchtesgadener Alps National Park is a wonderful conservation area with mountains at over 2,700 meters, Watzmann Mountain. And there is also there the crystal clear Lake of Königssee, a very important touristic attraction. And we are now heading towards Traunstein and Ruhpolding. We are climbing about 200 meters from the Salzach River Valley through these hills, and then we'll descend through the Traun Valley to the exit to Traunstein and Ruhpolding. Traunstein is a very nice stop on the way, with a nice historical center to visit. So if you have time, just go there and see the nice town. I said a few words about it as I drove from Wasserburg to Traunstein. Please feel free to check that video also. Ruhpolding is a nice small town in the mountains, so it's south of the motorway. Traunstein is north of the motorway, and it is a base for nice treks around and a very known base for biathlon. After Traunstein, the motorway finds its way over some green hills to the big lake of Chiemsee. The drive is very nice until there, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride with some music. And I'll be back as we approach the lake to say a few words about it. And here I am back again, as I promised, as we are driving on the south shore of the Chiemsee Lake. The motorway is built directly near the lake, and there is a nice rest area when driving westbound where you can stop exactly on the shore. Chiemsee is a big freshwater lake, often called the Bavarian Sea. It lies in the Chiemgau region, a famous recreation area, and has a surface of almost 80 square kilometers. There are three islands on the lake: the Herreninsel, or Gentleman's Island in English, it's the biggest one; the Fraueninsel, or Ladies Island; and the uninhabited and small Krautinsel. Herreninsel has a palace built by King Ludwig II in 1878 called Herrenchiemsee. This palace was meant to be a replica of Versailles, and it was never completed. But nowadays many rooms are open to the tourists and you can visit it. There are tours of the castle, of the palace. The other island, the Fraueninsel, the smaller one, houses a Benedictine nunnery. It's very, very old. It was built in the 8th century, as well as a small village. The nuns make nowadays very good liquor called cluster liquor and marzipan. And now I want you to show you a few pics of the Herrenchiemsee Palace and the lake before driving further on to Rosenheim. I hope you liked the few pics from the lake, and now let's drive further towards Rosenheim. There are plans to enlarge the motorway, to rebuild it on a 3+3 alignment, but there is a lot of opposition from the locals, and it's totally unsure if they will be able to do it. It will be nice for the commuters, but surely a little bit of nature destruction it will cause near the Chiemsee. But I hope they can find a good compromise between these two different interests. And now let's enjoy the drive further to Rosenheim. We are still at the foothills of the Alps through a very nice area, and I will come back near Rosenheim to tell you some words about it. Thank you. And I am back as we are getting closer to Rosenheim. And while you enjoy the last kilometers of the drive, I want to give you some information about the nice town of Rosenheim, a regional center in the German Inn Valley. Rosenheim is located at the confluence between Mangfall and Inn rivers at an altitude of about 450 meters and has about 63,000 inhabitants. It was first mentioned in 1234 and developed very fast as a hub for all types of goods that were transported on the Inn. Until the 7th century, it grew into one of the largest and most important market town in Bavaria. A further impulse to the economic growth came as the railways were built in the region. Rosenheim is an important junction between the main lines from Munich to Salzburg and the line to Innsbruck. Even if the town was heavily bombed during the Second World War, a big part of the historical center survived or was rebuilt afterwards. So Rosenheim is nowadays a very nice to visit town. There are also some nice museums like the Inn Museum, the Wood Technology Museum, or the Locomotives Museum to visit. At the end of the video, I put some photos from Rosenheim. They are from my friend Cinxxx. Please feel free to visit also his YouTube channel or his Flickr account. I will link them in the description of the video. Because I visited Rosenheim a few times, it's not far from where I live now. But I never took nice photos in the town, which is a little bit of a pity. But I have the photos from Cinxxx. They are very, very nice, I think. And I hope you like the drive through Bavaria. And if it is like this, just please push also the like button in YouTube. And for questions, suggestions, please feel free to leave me a comment. And if you generally like what I do and want to see more 4K quality road tourings videos, just subscribe to my channel, as I will post twice per week on Tuesdays and Saturdays new videos. With that being said, I am saying bye bye for now and will finish the video after the exit Rohrdorf, from where you can access Rosenheim from the east. So bye bye for now, till the next time, and don't forget the photos from Rosenheim that will come now.